South Carolina high school freshman. Now, here's another one. Here's another story right here. Here's another one. I'm going to read these two back to back. I did this on purpose. It shows the absurdity of what the hell is going on in this country today. It's beyond absurdity. I don't know what word is beyond absurd. I looked in the dictionary, and I couldn't find any word that went above absurd. But whatever that word is, I'm sure there's a word somewhere. I'm sure there's a wordsmith out there in the world that can come up with a word more than absurd. Whatever that word is, if you know it, okay, fine, you know it. But whatever that word is, that's what it is. A South Carolina high school. Now, I don't know what the hell's going on with South Kakalaki here lately. But they're a little better than this, you would think. You would think Carolina high school student was arrested and suspended. Not arrested. Not only suspended, but arrested. Arrested. That means handcuffs, thrown in the back of a squad car, fingerprinted, mugshotted. A South Carolina high school student was arrested and suspended after handing in a class assignment in which he wrote about killing his neighbor's pet dinosaur. Let's say that again. This is the absurdity part. A South Carolina high school student, was arrested and suspended after handing in a class assignment in which he wrote about killing his neighbor's pet dinosaur with a gun that he purchased to take care of the business. Okay. Now, you can't say gun in schools anymore, which is ridiculous. It's just absolutely ridiculous. Now, again, I know, here it is. Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech unless it involves the word gun. Well, that's not in this Constitution. Bacon is in our Constitution. Not being able to say the word gun is not in our Constitution. Why is nobody fighting this? I don't know. Cowards, 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 I guess. I don't know. But I'm sick of it, and I have no more patience for it, and I'm not about to have any patience for it or tolerance. And neither should you. Nobody should. This is ridiculous now. Freshman Alex Stone said it was only a joke, which obviously it is. His mother, Karen, was irate that he got busted. Irate? I think I'd be a little bit more irate. I'd be a lot irate. But look, here's how I take it. And I haven't even read the whole article yet. But if the kid wrote about killing his neighbor's pet dinosaur, a pet dinosaur. Now, when was the last time you seen a pet dinosaur? Honey, you seen any pet dinosaurs? Ah, go back to your Kim Kardashian show. Shut up. There are no more pet dinosaurs. They don't exist anymore. They've been extinct. But I guess nobody told anybody in South Carolina that the dinosaurs have been extinct. This is a creative writing. A creative writing assignment. The teacher should have done this. You know what? This is pretty creative. A pet dinosaur? Oh, but he used the word gun. Oh, well, now we've got to suspend him. Now we've got to take him out of class. Now we've got to call the cops. Now, what kind of cop? What kind of self-respecting cop? What the hell kind of a coward piece of crap are you, cop, that you're going to arrest a high school kid because he wrote about killing his neighbor's pet dinosaur with a gun? Cop, are you paying attention? Are you listening? What the hell is the matter with you? How the hell could you possibly put handcuffs on a kid, a teenager, on anybody for writing about killing his neighbor's pet dinosaur with a gun? What's the matter with you, cop? What the hell's the matter with you? You make me sick. You make me sick. That's another coward right there. See, that's a bully. And bullies are cowards. Cowards are bullies. And you, cop, you, whoever put the handcuffs on this kid, you not only are a coward, you are a creep. Cops like you should not be cops. This is what again, it's not the police force that I have a problem with. We all need a police force. We know they got a crappy job. We know they got a dangerous job. But this is not their goddamn job to arrest teenagers for writing a creative writing story about killing his neighbor's pet dinosaur. You do not have the right to arrest anybody for that, cop. Shame on you. Somebody should arrest you for arresting this kid. That's what should happen. That's what should happen. Does it? No. Gray said Somerville High School administrators acted rashly when they reported her son to the cops last Tuesday on the second day of school. The second day of school. The second day of school. This kid has to get arrested. I could understand if they made him rewrite it because he did have gun in it. But a pet dinosaur? That's what the parents said. A pet dinosaur. Well, that's what I said as soon as I read that. A pet dinosaur. This is obviously a creative writing class, I would think. I don't know. But the mother told CBS affiliate WCSC, I mean, first of all, we don't have dinosaurs anymore. Second of all, he's not even old enough to buy a gun. Alex 16, which the reason why buying a gun, because he said with a gun that he purchased to take care of the business. So the cops took this literally. Oh, this kid's out there, he purchased a gun, and now he wants to kill the neighbor's pet dinosaur. Let's see, where'd you get that gun? Where's that gun? Where are you hiding it? Huh? Where's that gun? Oh, yeah, you don't have any. You want to kill that dinosaur. What did that dinosaur do to you, kid? Huh? You want to go around killing pet dinosaurs? Well, we're going to throw you in jail. Shame on you, cop. Shame on you. You could have spent that time out there finding somebody, I don't know, maybe in Ferguson, Missouri, that was burning a building down. I don't know. You could have found somebody that was actually committing a crime. Someone who was an actual threat to society. But did you? No, you didn't. You're a coward and you're a creep. Alex 16 got in trouble after his classmates were told to write a Facebook-like update about themselves in a few sentences. Okay. I regret it because they put it on my record, but I don't see the harm in it, Alex told the station. There is no harm in it, kid. There is no harm in what you did. You followed the assignment. Write a Facebook-like update. Okay. Facebook, everybody, Facebook updates, people, I'm glad you should read my Facebook updates. I'm always coming up with crap. It's garbage, it's junk, it's fun. It's not meant to be taken literally, you idiots. My God, it's a pet dinosaur, for Christ's sakes. There are no more dinosaurs. And even if he says he's going to kill my neighbor's dog, so? So? How many people died because somebody wrote down on there, I'm going to kill you? How many people have died? Write down on a piece of paper. Write down on a piece of paper that you want to kill somebody and see how long it takes before they're killed. And you give me a reason why this kid's got to be removed from society because he's such a big threat. He's out there killing pet dinosaurs. His lawyer, David Aylor, said in a statement Thursday that Alex's arrest is a perfect example of political correctness that has exceeded the boundaries of common sense. Whoa. I mean, that's an understatement of what you just said. I agree with you, David. I agree with you, but it's an understatement. This is just downright freaking criminal. This is criminal. If you are going to remove a child from society, handcuff him, fingerprint him, mugshot him, because of this, that is a crime. That is a crime that the teachers committed. That is a crime that the cops committed. Well, evidently he gets to return to school on Monday. After cops were called, they searched Alex's locker and book bag. The school suspended Alex for 3 days. They suspended this kid for 3 days for this. Well, if the parent had any sense about them at all, they'd remove him from the frickin' school and go get yourself a private school if you can afford it. If you can afford it, get your ass out of the public schools. If you've got a child and you can afford private education, do it. The public system, the public education system in this country today, it's not worth it. You're not educating your children. You're indoctrinating them. You're making them stupid. You're making them stupider and stupider and stupider every day they go into a public classroom. And this right here is a perfect example of it. This is evidence. Aren't you teachers supposed to be smarter than the students? Don't you think that somebody in that school, a teacher, a principal, a goddamn janitor, for Christ's sakes, should have said, hey, wait a minute, this is a pet dinosaur, you idiot. It's a Facebook post. It's not real, sweetheart. It's not real. Jesus, God. And the Somerville Police Department defended the arrest. How do you defend this? They said Alex was charged with disorderly conduct when he became disruptive after school officials confronted him after what he wrote. And I don't blame him. I would have been disruptive, too. I would have told you all to go kiss my ass, and I would have walked out of the school. That's right, cop. He was disruptive. Maybe if you took the time to find out why the kid was disruptive, maybe you should have put the handcuffs on the goddamn teacher, you frickin' idiot. What the hell is the matter with the police department, man? What is going on? You only put handcuffs on. Let me tell you something, cops. I don't care what your goddamn cop handbook says. I care what the Constitution says. And the Constitution trumps cop handbooks. You do not remove people from society until they are a direct, imminent threat to society. How is this kid a threat to society? Because he gets a little uppity? Because his teachers were hounding him for this? I don't blame him. This kid's got every goddamn right to be disruptive. And what does that word disruptive mean? Well, to a teacher, the fact that you just show up. You don't have to say anything. Just a look is all you need. That's disruptive. The charges do not stem from anything involving a dinosaur or writing assignment, but the student's conduct, Captain John Rogers, said in a statement Thursday. Well, Captain John Rogers, you're an asshole. Period. And that's all we got tonight. I want to thank everybody listening here tonight, everybody on their smartphones, and everybody that's going to download later. Thank you very much. Hey, look, if you like the show, tell your friends. Tell your neighbors. Tell your enemies. I don't care. Tell them to join the fun. We have a lot of fun on this show. We'll see you back here tomorrow night at 8. Goodbye, everybody.